Where do you think you're going?
I'm taking my goods to Omega, Detective.
You're not going anywhere, Merchant. Not until I solve this murder.
I had nothing to do with that. It was those mercenary thugs you can't seem to get rid of.
The victim was your business partner, and I'm not ruling you out. I'll let you know when you can leave.
What about that Justicar that just showed up? Everyone says she might go crazy and start killing. I need to leave.
She'll only kill the unjust, so I'm sure you have nothing to worry about, Pitney Four. Find me in the station if you need me.
What do you want? I've already got mercs wanting to kill me like they did my partner. I don't need any more trouble. As if that weren't enough, some Asari Justicar showed up this morning. All the natives are scared of her. I've got to get off this world.
Has Samara actually done anything yet?
The Asari say that Justicars are lethal in a fight. And if they so much as smell corruption, they start shooting. The thing is, corruption isn't that hard to find around here.
Tell me how to find the Justicar.
She's in the alley where my business partner was murdered. A detective sealed the area, so you'll have to talk with her if you want to go there.
Why do you think it was mercenaries?
Dagny Kerr was cutting through a back alley last night when someone killed him with a shotgun. I saw his body this morning. They'd used modded rounds. That means Eclipse mercs.
You must know something about these Eclipse.
I occasionally do business with them. But only in well-lit places. With my guards. And only after the cred's clear. This is a scummy bunch, even by merc standards. They sell red sand, all kinds of illegal items, and they are all cold-blooded killers.
Why would these mercs kill him? And why do you think they're coming after you, too?
I have no idea. We're innocent merchants. But they killed him, so they must be after me, too. I have to work the angles and get out of here.
You don't seem too broken up about your partner's death.
Dagny Kerr knew the risks when he took to spacing. Right now, my worry is me. It's unhealthy to be a Volus in the Nosastra spaceport right now. Especially a Volus named Pitney Four.
I should go.
Cops don't admit it, but the Eclipse sisters run this area.
I wanted to be a Justicar when I was young. Every Asari does, I guess.
Nice guns. Try not to use them in my district. What can I do for you?
I'm looking for an Asari warrior named Samara.
If you've got a score to settle with Samara, take it somewhere else. I've got more than enough trouble here already.
I need to recruit Samara for my mission. Then we'll be on our way.
Justicars usually work alone. But they are drawn to impossible causes.
We've got that covered.
If you're getting her out of my district, I'll get you to her ASAP. She's at the crime scene.
You're letting her into a sealed crime scene?
I'm a cop. I'll work with the Justicar all I can. Besides, she's been looking at crime scenes longer than our two lifespans combined. She knows how to handle herself.
You're awfully anxious to get Samara out of your district.
My bosses want me to detain her. They're worried she'll cause some kind of cross-species incident. But her Justicar code won't let her be taken into custody. If I try it, she'll have to kill me. I have no interest in dying, so if you lure her away with some big noble cause before I have to carry out my orders, I'm thrilled to help you.
Your superiors are sending you to certain death for no good reason. You have a right to disobey.
Let's remember that next time Shepard sets us up against impossible odds.
That's about twice a day.
Most of the time, I'm not being stupid about it. I can't say the same for Anaya's superiors.
I'm a cop and I know my duty. I've been ordered to detain her and I will. Unless I can get her to leave my district first.
Samara would kill a cop? That doesn't sound very just.
She would die defending an honest cop, but she'd fight an army of dirty cops to the death. I admire her dedication, but her presence is still a big problem. I need her gone before I have to carry out my orders.
How do I get to the crime scene?
It's around the corner. Go outside, take a left. Look for the police line. I'll send word to let you in. Be careful. The local Eclipse mercs have been all over those back alleys lately.
You mentioned a crime scene?
A Volus merchant was murdered. It was a professional hit, so we're not dealing with junkies looking for a score. I'm thinking the local Eclipse mercenary band. Can't prove it, but if the Volus was dirty too, maybe it's just a deal gone bad.
What do I need to know about these mercenaries?
Eclipse mercs are professional killers. They sell red sand, trade illegal weapons tech, and smuggle criminals off-world. They control some back alleys around here. I haven't been able to find their nest yet, though.
What can you tell me about Justicars?
They're a kind of... humans might call them warrior monks. They live by a complex code that compels them to punish the wicked and protect the pure. They've been a part of Asari culture for millennia. I read adventure stories about Justicars when I was a child.
What do you think of Samara herself?
She's been a Justicar longer than three of your lifespans. Whoever she was before she swore that oath, that person is dead.
People seem nervous about Samara's presence.
Asari admire Justicars, but we also know that they kill without mercy when they find corruption. And Justicars never leave Asari space. Why is she here? I doubt it's to investigate the murder of some corrupt Volas.
I have to go.
Good luck.
We'd better find Samara before the detective goes after her. Anaya told us to let you through. Watch yourself. There's merc activity back here. We're waiting on backup.
Those were my best troops.
Tell me what I need to know, and I will be gone from here. Where did you send her?
You think I'd betray her? She would hurt me in ways you can't imagine.
The name of the ship. Your life hangs on the answer, Lieutenant.
You can kill me, but one of us will take you down, Justicar.
Ugh. was the name of the ship she left on?
Go to hell!
Find peace in the embrace of the goddess. My name is Samara, a servant of the Justicar Code. My quarrel is with these Eclipse Sisters, but I see three well-armed people before me. Are we friend or foe?
That merc was wounded and helpless. Do you just kill anyone who won't help you?
If my cause is important enough, yes. Are you different?
I've killed enemies, but always with good reason.
I answer to a code that is clearly defined. If my actions are true to that code, I am just. If they are not, I am unjust. I don't pretend it is a simple matter, or that it seems right to everyone. But I sleep well at night, and that is more than most can say. How may I be of service to you?
I'm going up against suicidal odds, and I need the best. That's you.
I sense the truth in what you say, and it humbles me. But I seek an incredibly dangerous fugitive. I cornered her here, but the Eclipse Sisters smuggled her off-world. I must find the name of the ship she left on before the trail goes cold.
I wish you were willing to go with the human, Justicar. I've been ordered to take you into custody if you won't leave.
You risk a great deal by following your orders, Detective. Fortunately, I will not have to resist. My code obligates me to cooperate with you for one day. After that, I must return to my investigation.
I won't be able to release you that soon.
You won't be able to stop me.
The human is lost here. Can one of you clarify?
I was trying to convince her to leave with you, but Justicar is in their code.
The detective has been ordered to detain me. I can't force her to disobey an order.
And after a day, Samara fights her way out of custody, killing anyone in her way?
I am afraid so.
There must be some way we can all get what we need.
I see a way. While I am in custody, you find the name of that ship. Do that, and I will join you. Then the code will be satisfied.
This Justicar code seems quite strict.
It may seem so to you, but this is my oath. The expedient path may be fast and simple, but does not make it the right path.
Can you tell me more about Justicars?
We are individuals who have forsworn family, children, and worldly possessions aside from some weapons and armor. We travel asari space righting wrongs as defined by the ancient code we have each memorized.
Illium may be dominated by asari, but it isn't in asari space.
My quarry fled to this place. I am sworn to hunt her down, and I will follow anywhere she goes. It is rare for a Justicar to leave asari space, but I must follow my oath. If I suffer for it, I will accept that.
A moment ago, you refused to give up your investigation, but now you'll swear to follow me?
If I stay, I will be compelled to kill many innocents to escape incarceration.
Like me.
I may be killed, and my quarry would be free to continue murdering. If I come with you and survive your mission, I can resume my investigation. To do that, I need the ship's name to track her to her next hiding place. It is a simple choice.
Makes sense.
Do you have any leads?
The Volus merchant Pitney IV is tied to this. Eclipse mercs are preparing to kill him. Get the truth out of him. He may know a way into the Eclipse base.
Well, I've got to get back to my station. And I guess I've got to take you with me.
Thank you, Shepard.
Hello again, Earth Clan. Did you speak to the detective?
Why are the mercs after you?
I know nothing about any mercenaries, Earth Clan. I'm merely an innocent merchant trying to make his way in life.
The Eclipse are out for your blood. I need your help to break into their base. Shouldn't we work together?
Yes. You're right, Earth Clan. I'm desperate. I've got angry mercs after me, and now this Asari Justicar. Let's talk. I smuggled a chemical onto Illium that boosts biotic powers in combat. It also is toxic. I may have, forgotten to mention that to the Eclipse, so they are perturbed and want to kill me.
Tell me about this chemical you brought in.
It's called Minogen X3, and it's very, very, illegal. Anyone with biotic powers who is exposed to it becomes more powerful. The higher your exposure, the more powerful you get. But too much of it, you die. That's the part that the Eclipse found disagreeable.
It sounds like you're a swindler and your actions finally caught up with you.
True and true. But I haven't survived as a merchant this long without being able to tell when there's a deal in the making. You want something.
The Eclipse recently smuggled someone off-world. I need the name of the ship she left on.
I don't know about their people smuggling operations. They must keep records in their base. I do have a pass card they issued me to bring my goods in. Well, I had to return that one, but I happened to make a copy. Take it. But be careful. Each Eclipse sister commits a murder to earn her uniform. They are all dangerous.
I hear you can buy red sand from the Eclipse. Just don't cross it.
I don't trust that Volus.
Find a way into the Eclipse hideout. Wasea, their leader, must have a record of the ship name.
Please don't start trouble about my prisoner. Trust me, I'd release her right now if I could. It's a great honor to have a Justicar here, but I could do without the honor of having her kill me.
I'd like to avoid killing you, Detective. Unfortunately, the moment my code dictates I must, I will. There is only the code.
She says this kind of thing like she's talking about what to eat for dinner.
You're not gonna lock her up?
Any attempt to put me in a passive restraint system will be regarded as a hostile action, and I will be forced to attack.
Yeah, that.
Don't let
Wait, stop! I didn't fire my weapon once. I pretended to because the other Eclipse sisters were watching, but I didn't really shoot. I'm not one of them. I'm new. I thought being Elnora the mercenary would be cool, but I didn't know what they were really like.
You chose your side, Elnora, and you lost.
Screw that, bitch!
This might be useful.
Threat detected. Rerouting power.
It's official. Little baby Elnora is finally a full-fledged Eclipse merc. I earned my uniform last night when I killed that ridiculous bolus. Up close, exploding rounds. Blew the little bastard's suit wide open. I can't wait to see some real action. Next time I go home, my friends are gonna be so jealous.
Hostiles detected. Thank you.
This looks like a shipping manifest. It shows that Pitney 4 sold 2,000 units of Minigen X3 to the Eclipse, along with 600 units of Red Sand.
This isn't the information Samara needs, but it proves that the Volus is a criminal.
I'm sure Detective Anaya would be interested in this. We gotta keep moving.
Biotic god. I think things, and they happen. Fear me, lesser creatures, for I am biotics made flesh.
You need help.
You need help. You stand before the mightiest biotic ever. Yes, the Asari injecting so many drugs into me was terrifying. But then I began to smell my greatness. They may laugh when I fall over, but they don't know what I know in my head. That I know that I am amazingly powerful. Fear me!
Are you part of Pitney Force trade group?
When I was mortal, I worked for Pitney. Poor soul is probably terrified that I have not returned.
He hasn't reported your disappearance. Probably so his departure won't get delayed.
Face it, Pitney will pick money over friends every time.
Bah! I will wreak a just revenge upon his people. But first, the leader of these mercenaries is in the next room. I shall toss Wasaya about like a rag doll.
Shepard, having this incapacitated Volus running around our battlefield could compromise us.
I will tear her apart. My biotics are unstoppable.
Wasaya will tear you apart. Take a nap, you'll feel better.
Are you mad? I'm unstoppable. Feasting on her biotic-rich blood will be the last step. But, great wind, biotic god, what was I saying? I'm tired. Yes, I'm tired. I'll nap. Destroy the universe later.
So much for godhood.
Everything's gone to hell since we smuggled that filthy creature off-world. First a Justicar shows up. Now you. At least I can take pleasure in turning your head into a pulpy mass!
Enemies in sight! Come on!
Concussive shot, Red.
record of that ship must be around here.
That must be the ship Samara was looking for.
Should we head back to the police station and give her the name, or look around first?
Let's give her the name and keep moving.
I don't know what they put in me, but I thought I was... Well, you saw. Anyway, thank you, Shepard.
Thank you for removing the Eclipse threat, Earth Clan. It will take them months to rebuild their organization. Also, merely out of curiosity, when you were poking about, did you perhaps run across a shipping manifest that belongs to me?
You never know when something like this might come in handy.
If it might change your mind, Earth Clan, returning that manifest would be very profitable for you. If you give it to the detective, her reward will be a pat on the back.
Got the name of the ship. Your fugitive left here 2 days ago on the AML Demeter.
Shepard, you impress me. You fulfilled your part of the bargain, and I will fulfill mine. I am ready to leave immediately, if that will satisfy your superiors, Detective.
You're free to go, Justicar. It has been an honor having you in my station. And it's nice you didn't kill me, too.
Sworn to follow a code that dictates your decisions, but I'm running a military operation.
You wonder if I will refuse to follow orders because of my code?
I can't allow that to happen.
By agreeing to follow you, I am compelled to swear the most difficult of Justicar oaths, the third oath of subsummation. After I do, your orders will override the code. You should know, however, that I'll still give you my opinion if the situation warrants.
The Normandy is docked near the main trading floor. I'll see you aboard.
I must be sworn to your service so that I am never forced to choose between your orders and the code. By the code, I will serve you, Shepard. Your choices are my choices. Your morals are my morals. Your wishes are my code.
I never thought I'd see a Justicar swear an oath like that.
If you make me do anything extremely dishonorable, I may need to kill you when I'm released from my oath.
I can see that this is a very important act, Samara. Thank you.
Truly, the life of a Justicar can get lonely. I admit I am looking forward to serving with a company of honorable heroes. Shall we return to your ship?
I need to speak to the detective.
Thanks for getting Samara out of my district. I can tell my granddaughters about meeting a Justicar. And you've just upped my chances of living long enough to have grandkids.
I have proof that Eclipse killed the Volus merchant.
Let's see what you got there. Interesting. But I can't verify it. It would be inadmissible.
I vouch for Shepard and any evidence she brings forward.
I accept the judgment of the Justicar. Thanks, Shepard. I wasn't sure about trusting a stranger, and a human at that. But you came through. Never heard of this Elnora. Sounds like she was just starting her career. Good thing you cut it short. Okay, enough with all the congratulations. I've still got a spiraling crime rate.
I have proof that Pitney 4 smuggled in red sand and illegal weapons tech.
I'll send in some officers to arrest him and his cohorts. This is a big help, Shepard. I can't do much to thank you, but we do have a small discretionary bounty fund. Take this.
Welcome to the Normandy, Samara. We've studied your profile extensively. With your skills, I think you'll be an excellent addition to our team.
Thank you. From an organization such as yours, that is high praise indeed.
I've seen Samara's biotic powers at work. They're substantial.
We still don't know what we're going to find when we hit the collectors.
I will be prepared for whatever we encounter.
Where shall we put you?
A room that looks out on the great empty void would be most comforting.
Put her in the observation room on Deck 3.
Thank you. I must meditate on the day's events.
There is nothing more absolute than the oath of an Asari Justicar. You did well getting Samara on our side. She is so elegant and gorgeous. Too bad her manner is just so cold.
Is there anything I should know?
You have unread messages at your private terminal. Anything else, Commander?
That'll be all.
Take care. Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
Understand. I lost it somewhere near the transport terminal. It can't be replaced. It's a token from my bondmate. It's the only thing my child has to remember her father by. Please, if you find it... No, I understand.
How can you short sell on prefabs after these human colony attacks?
Lots of money here. Soft people who'd make good victims. This place is one bad day away from becoming Omega.
Scum considers itself protected.
Damn it! This is just a misunderstanding!
Tell it to the judge. My surveillance vids caught your extortion attempt from 4 different angles.
I was misled! I was told that you had agreed to sell!
Take her away, before I have my bartender throw her out.
What happened? The undercover cop from the weapons kiosk just got arrested.
She wasn't a cop. She was a deep cover operative from a terrorist cell. I'd never have found her if not for you.
Really?
Really. You did a great job, Conrad. Now please, go home. Let me take it from here.
Can do, Shepard. And thanks. It's really good to have you back.
Welcome back, babe. Can I get you anything? Sorry, no sex. Just cleaned the bar.
Just looking around.
Pleasure as always.
If you're hurting for things to do, maybe you have to go.
Ms. Lawson, I'm glad you've made it. We've had a complication.
What happened? Is Ariana all right?
She's fine, but you listed a man named Niket as your trusted source. He contacted me, warning that your father has sent Eclipse mercenaries to make a sweep. He suggested that the Mercs might be watching for you personally. He's offered to escort Ariana's family to the terminal instead.
You didn't mention anything about Niket.
He's a friend. He and I go back a long way.
Do you want to bring in any of your other Illium contacts, Ms. Lawson?
No. You and Niket are the only two I trust on this.
What information do you have about the mercenaries?
I've confirmed that they're Eclipse, and that they're working for an organization Ms. Lawson warned us about. I could try to alert the authorities, but so far they've done nothing illegal.
You made the right decision. We'll handle this ourselves.
It's your sister, Miranda. What do you want to do?
Lantea, we'll follow Niket's suggestion. Shepard and I will take the car and draw their attention. Have Niket escort the family to the shuttle. Give him full access to the family's itinerary, just to be safe.
Understood, Ms. Lawson.
So the plan is for us to get shot down by Eclipse while your sister gets to safety?
Eclipse will be under orders to take my sister alive. They won't risk anything that could kill us.
I doubt Eclipse will send all their people just to stop you. Do you want to give Niket any backup?
Niket can take care of himself. Besides, any armed backup just draws attention to him.
I'm ready whenever you are, Miranda.
Thank you, Shepard. I appreciate this. I hadn't planned on Eclipse, but they never planned on you. Damn it! Eclipse mercenary gunships. They'll be dropping troops in the cargo areas.
Down in that cover behind them.
Let's hope they really do want to take us alive.
Hold fire! I said hold fire, damn it!
I got this.
Since you're not firing yet, I trust you know who I am.
Yeah, they said you'd be in the car. You're the bitch that kidnapped our boss's little girl.
Kidnapped? This doesn't involve you. I suggest you take your men and go.
Think you've got it all lined up, huh? Captain Inyal is already moving in on the kid. She knows about Niket. He won't be helping you.
Wait, Miranda, you said she was your twin sister.
That what she told you? No, this crazy bitch kidnapped our boss's baby daughter. He's been looking for her for more than a decade.
It's complicated, Shepard. We share the same DNA, just not the same birthday.
You took a baby from the richest guy in the galaxy, lady. I don't know what your damage is, but you're not getting away with it.
What do you mean, Niket won't be helping us?
Nothing you need to worry about. Nobody's gonna get killed unless you do something stupid. You walk away now, the girl goes back to her father, and everybody's happy.
Everybody but my sister. And me.
Should we be talking to Captain Inyala about this?
You don't want to talk to the captain. She's not as polite as I am. She's the best commando I've ever seen. I've seen her tear people in half with her biotics. And she's getting paid a lot to stop you.
She gets in my way, she'll never have a chance to spend it.
You're not getting Miranda's sister. If you push this, it'll go badly for you.
Captain Inyala ordered us to give you one chance to walk away. This whole time we've been talking, my men have been lining up shots. When I say the word, we unleash hell on your squad. So I suggest you walk away nicely, unless you want things to get ugly.
They've seen us.
Hang on, I've got one of their radios. I'll patch us in, see if I can get an idea of what we're up against. Shepard, I think I owe you an explanation. Ariana is my twin, genetically. But my father grew her when I was a teenager. She was meant to replace me. I couldn't let my father do to her what he did to me. So I rescued her. She's almost a woman now.
I can understand choosing to go your own way, but you stole a young child from her father.
If you knew my father, you would understand. I wasn't the first one he made, I was only the first one he kept. I was brought up with no friends, pushed to meet impossible demands. I wasn't a daughter to him. I was... I don't know what I was. Ariana has had a normal life. I made the right decision.
Why didn't you tell me that we were saving a kid?
She's not a child. She'll be 19 this year. But, well, it didn't seem relevant at the time, I suppose. There are people who'd use her against me. I'm very protective when it comes to Ariana. I'm sorry I didn't trust you sooner. You deserved to know.
If Eclipse knows where Ariana is, they'll be moving in on her soon. We need to hurry.
Agreed. I'm a bit worried by what the Merc said. If they've got to Niket somehow, this is going to be harder than I'd planned. According to the specs I reviewed, we'll need to cut through the cargo processing yard to get to Ariana.
I hope your friend can be trusted.
Absolutely. Niket is one of my oldest friends. I guess you could say he was my only real friend. He's the only person I didn't cut ties with when I left my father.
Is there a chance your father could be using Niket to get to you?
I'm sure he's tried, but Niket's one of the few people who understands what my father is really like. I trusted him with my life when I ran from my father, Shepard. He won't betray me now.
Can you tell me anything about the cargo processing yard?
We'll be moving through conveyor systems. There'll be a lot of movement. Finding targets won't be easy. We'll need to stay sharp. And these cargo transports carry hazardous materials. So watch what you shoot at.
Let's go find Niket and Ariana.
Right.
They're on the far side of the conveyor line. Time your shots.
We've been spotted.
Got no shield!
Back. The kid is nearing the transport terminal.
This should come in handy.
Maybe the captain knows we're listening in, and she's feeding misinformation about Niket making a switch. Or maybe it means something else. Niket wouldn't do that. Damn it, why won't this thing go any faster?
What makes you so sure that Niket wouldn't turn on you?
He could have turned on me when I ran away. I'm sure my father tried to buy him off. If he didn't do it then, why would he do it now?
Did Niket know that you took Oriana from your father?
No, he just found out about that recently. It was too personal to involve someone else. I never really thought about it, but maybe... No, he'd have to understand why I did it. He knows what I went through.
We won't know anything until we find Niket.
And then I'll have a word with this captain and Yala.
Listen to me. I've got authorization to change their booking.
I'm sorry, sir. We're under security lockdown. Until the situation in the cargo terminal is resolved, no passengers can be rebooked.
This isn't worth my time, Niket.
I get paid regardless of how the girl gets there.
No. I was told that I could handle this my way. We're not traumatizing the family any more than we... Miri.
This should be fun.
Niket, you sold me out.
How do you want to handle this, Miranda?
Why, Niket? You were my friend. You helped me get away from my father.
Yes, because you wanted to leave. That was your choice. But if I'd known that you'd stolen a baby...
I didn't steal her. I rescued her.
From a life of wealth and happiness? You weren't saving her. You were getting back at your father.
How did Miranda's father turn you?
They told me you kidnapped your baby sister all those years ago. They said I could help get her back peacefully. No trauma to the family. I told them you'd never do that. They could go to hell. And you finally told me what you'd done. I called them back that night.
Why didn't you call me, Niket? We've been through a lot. You could have at least let me explain.
I deserve to know that you'd stolen your sister, Miri. I deserve to know you were with Cerberus. But I had to hear it from your father first.
How much did Miranda's father pay you?
A great deal.
Damn it, Niket! You were the only one I trusted from that life.
He knew you felt that way. That's why he bought me.
So you just took his money?
Don't get holy with me, Miri. You took his money for years.
Whether or not you agree with Miranda, Oriana has been with her family for years now.
Her father can still give her a better life.
You don't know what my father wants for her.
I know that I've been poor, Miri. I didn't much care for it.
He wants to take a girl away from the only family she's ever known. Doesn't that tell you what he really is?
I knew Eclipse was willing to get their hands dirty, but kidnapping a kid?
I'm not stealing her. I'm rescuing her. Come on, Niket. Let's finish this bitch off and get out of here.
Take your best shot.
I was just waiting for you to finish getting dressed. Or does Cerberus really let you whore around in that outfit?
I like her. Are we still recruiting? If you're working for Miranda's father, that means he knows about Oriana. We need to find a new solution.
Miranda's father has no information about Oriana. I knew you had spy programs in your father's system, Miri, so I kept it private. I'm the only one who knows.
Which means that you're the only loose end. This isn't how I wanted it to end, Niket. I'm going to miss you.
Miranda, wait. You don't want to do this.
This has to end here, Shepard. My father will keep trying to find Oriana.
Maybe Niket can help. Talk to your father. Just say you got here first.
I'll tell him that you hid her. That I don't know where she is.
I never want to see you again, Niket.
Done. Now, if you don't mind, I have a shipment to deliver.
You'll die for that, bitch!
Prepare to attack!
How do you like that, Cerberus?
I want to make sure Oriana and her family get on safely. I can't believe Nikit sold me out. I didn't even see it coming.
Even with all your upgrades, you're human just like the rest of us.
But I let it get personal and I screwed up. Why didn't you let me kill him? I could have handled that. But watching him get gunned down by that asari bitch...
You still cared for him, even if he betrayed you.
You're right. And my father knew it. He used that against me. It's always been like this. My father gave me anything I ever wanted. But there was always a hook, an angle for his long-term plan. I threw away everything he ever gave me when I ran. Except Nikit. Weakness on my part?
You can't toss aside everything you care about just to be safe.
It's okay, Shepard. My father hurt me, but he didn't break me. As much as he tried to turn me into exactly what he wanted, I'm my own person.
Any other old friends your father might use against you?
No. I cut ties with everyone else. Anyone I'm close to now works for Cerberus. Or you. My father's powerful, but he won't cross the elusive man.
You still have Orianna.
My father didn't give her to me. I rescued her. But yes, you're right. I still have something. Thank you. No sign of Eclipse. It looks like we're clear. There she is. She's safe. With her family. Come on, we should go.
Don't you even want to say hello?
It's not about what I want, it's about what's right for her. The less she knows about me, the better. She's got a family. A life. I'll just complicate that for her.
She doesn't need any details, but would it really be so bad for her to know she has a sister who loves her?
I guess not.
Go on. We'll wait here.
So then he says, we'll figure something out. It's okay, I'll think of something.
You said synthetic insights would buy me. You said it was an easy sale.
I assumed they would want an AI tech. Hello, can I help you with something?
Have you made this quarry in your slave?
We prefer the term indentured servants. Before you do anything hasty, know that this quarry signed the agreement voluntarily, and her servitude contract is completely legal on Illium. You actually want to help the quarry and convince the Synthetic Insights representative to purchase her contract.
Slavery is legal on Illium.
Indentured servitude lasts a set amount of time or until agreed upon conditions are met. Illium must approve all contracts. The law limits what restraint or corrective options I can use, and what tasks I can legally assign her. I'm also legally responsible for her behavior and health. Abuse is absolutely forbidden.
Why did this Quarian sign herself into slavery?
I tried to play the stock market. I'm good with numbers, and I thought I had a way to make unlimited money. I lost everything. Then I got a credit line and lost that. Then I took out an illegal loan. You get the picture.
As part of our agreement, I paid off her debts. 5 years from now, she'll have a fresh start and excellent work references.
Sounds great. Unless you lose her paperwork or come up with a reason to hold her longer.
All contracts are monitored by Illium Law Enforcement. In a case such as you described, the burden of proof would be on me. No system is perfect, but safeguards are set up to protect all parties.
If slavery's legal, then why are you trying to sell the Quarian?
I don't keep service contracts myself. I'm a contract broker. I assumed Synthetic Insights would jump at the chance for a skilled AI tech, but they won't even make me an offer.
Why not just keep her? You said she had technical skills.
Quarian's strict health requirements and diets make them expensive to house and feed. I run at a minor profit at best. I don't have the money for constant suit repairs and clean room facilities.
So, what happens if Synthetic Insights won't take me?
A solution always presents itself. I will take care of you.
I'll talk to the Synthetic Insights rep and see what I can do.
Really? Thank you. I'd appreciate that.
You deserve somebody who respects you. Somebody who's going to treat you.
Can I help you with something?
How'd you like to get your hands on an expert Quarian AI programmer?
If you'd like to submit a resume, I... Wait. Is this that slave? Synthetic Insights has no interest in purchasing slave labor. We're under enough scrutiny from the Citadel without engaging in practices the Council disapproves of. To be frank, we're hardly hiring anyone. The Geth attack on the Citadel didn't engender much love for artificial intelligence.
It sounds like Synthetic Insights is worried about its reputation. Hiring this Quarian would help.
Buying a slave helps our reputation. How exactly do you figure?
Purchase the contract, minus the fee for early emancipation, then free the Quarian and garnish wages for reimbursement.
Interesting. We look good for hiring a Quarian, and we can say that we freed slaves out of the goodness of our hearts. All right, I'll run up a contract. The board might wet its pants, but we could use the good publicity. This Quarian had better be good, though.
Synthetic Insights just sent over the contract. I cannot thank you enough.
I'm happy to help.
Here, for your trouble. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'll get this service contract transferred.
Thank you. I'll stay out of trouble this time.
Listen, I know the data is...
Serena?
Who wants to know?
Name's Shepard. Liara Tassoni said you might have information on Thane Krios.
Tana, cover for me. Over here. Yeah, I know who Thane Krios is. I might have passed him some information, but I didn't hire him. What do you want to know?
Maybe you could help me find him.
I can tell you, but you won't stop him. When he contacted me, I checked up on him. The man never gives up on a job. I ran security for Nasana Dantius. Then I found out she was having people killed to cover up her dirty secrets. She fired me when I confronted her. Her loss. I might have been good enough to stop Thane from taking her down.
Why does that name sound familiar?
She was a representative on the Citadel a few years ago.
Right. She had me kill her sister, the slaver.
I thought that was just a rumor. Well, you know what she's capable of, then. She has even more power here in Nos Astra. She uses it to keep her friends in check, and her enemies dead.
If you work there, you must have an idea what his opposition will be.
Eclipse mercs. High-tech killer. Undisciplined, but very well-equipped. They don't much care who they kill, as long as they're paid for it. Thane has quite a reception waiting for him. I told him all I knew. He didn't seem worried.
So where do I find Thane?
The Dantius Towers. Penthouse level of Tower 1. There's a second tower, still under construction. If Thane is smart, he'll go in from there.
It doesn't sound like Nisana's just gonna let me in.
She's as smart as she is paranoid. No one's getting in or out of there without a fight. I can get you in, but you'll only get one shot. You'd better be ready.
You're just offering your help. No strings attached?
You're going to look for Thane. Nisana's mercenaries will try to stop you. At the least, you'll distract her guards. Take a little fire, give Thane a clear shot. I didn't hire him to kill Nisana, but I won't shed any tears when she gets what's coming to her.
Do you know anything else about Thane?
Not much. He did say that he's not doing the hit for money. Nobody hired him. I wanted to know who I was helping, and he said he's doing this job on his own. That he had to restore the balance of his life. I don't know. Maybe he's crazy. If he takes down Nisana, I don't care why he does it.
Let's go then.
Good. I'm tired of this crap. We'll go tonight, as soon as the shift workers clear out of Tower 2. And you'll find more resistance closer to the penthouse. So, this assassin, you planning to stop him?
I'm just here to make sure he survives.
There they are, the Dantius Towers. You'll have to get up to the second tower and cross the bridge to the penthouse. Her mercs will fight you every step, but it's your best chance.
Why don't we just save time and take the shuttle up?
She's got mercs with rockets just waiting for you to try. You get maybe halfway up before they shot you down. Besides, your assassin won't go in that way. Best to go in low.
Any last-minute tips about the towers?
The Eclipse mercs will be well fortified by now, and they won't want to disappoint Nisana. There's no automated defenses or traps. Just focus on anything moving.
All right, let's do this.
Hold on. They'll be here to greet you soon enough. Good luck, Shepard.
Put them down.
You're still alive?
I can't feel my legs. My chest is killing me.
Who attacked you?
We're just night workers. Nasana sent them after us. She sent the mechs to round us up, but we didn't hear. They just started shooting.
They just attacked you?
Yes. They were too slow. It was horrible. Everyone screaming. The mechs said there was no time. Nasana wanted us out of the way. Immediately. Then... the dogs...
Here. That should ease the pain and keep you alive until help arrives.
He doesn't know where the assassin is.
Take your time.
I think I'm better. Find the other workers. Help them.
Why would Nasana kill her own workers?
Her were expendable, but I didn't realize she was that ruthless. My friends, co-workers, slaughtered. They were jumping off ledges to escape the dogs.
Any idea how many mercs Nasana's got?
A lot. Dozens of them are wandering around here all day. You'll find more the further up you go.
I need to get up to the penthouse. Any suggestions?
Take the service elevator to the upper floors. The bridge between the towers isn't finished, but if you're careful, watch out for the mercs. They're everywhere.
I need to get up to the penthouse. Any suggestions?
Take the service elevator to the upper floors. The bridge between the towers isn't finished, but if you're careful, watch out for the mercs. They're everywhere.
You should be safe here.
Thank you. I won't forget this.
Hey, I think he went in here.
We'll go get him.
You go.
Get your ass in there, and Nasana's not paying you to stand around.
Fine. But I... Fire.
ridiculous. We'll go. Hey, look. They're not Eclipse. You're here to help us, right?
It's one reason I'm here. Come on out. It's safe enough.
Thank you. We are in your debt.
Maybe you can help me. I'm looking for someone. Not a merc. He's on his own.
Well, whoever sealed us in here. When he found us, I thought we were dead. But he just closed the door and locked us in.
Could be him. But that doesn't sound much like an assassin.
Assassin? Here for Nasana, I bet. She's got it coming. You treat people like this, it always comes back to bite you in the ass.
How many workers were in the tower? Are there many more of you?
Not alive. We were lucky. Well, some got out before the dogs were sent in. Maybe a few are hiding somewhere.
I need to get to Nasana's penthouse. What's the quickest way?
Cargo elevator is the only way up right now. They're still working up top. Watch your step. Some of the walls aren't in, and it's a long way down. Cold, too. I hate working up there.
Nasana's not exactly your favorite person.
She's a hard woman to work for. That's an understatement. She works as long hours, no overtime, and this is what you get in payment. She's unpleasant, to say the least.
Why not just quit?
We would if we could.
What's stopping you?
Our contract. We're stuck until the job's done. Quitting for any reason can be hazardous to your health. We hear that anyone who leaves early tends to disappear. Probably just a rumor. But who wants to find out for sure?
Did you see the one who locked you in? Do you know where he might have gone?
He's no Solarian, I can tell you that. But I've no idea where he went. Sorry. If he's after Nasana, he'll be heading to the upper levels.
I wouldn't stay here too long. It should be safe down on the lower floors.
I was just thinking the same thing. Let's go, everybody! Thank you. And tell your assassin to aim for her head. Because she doesn't have a heart. Get moving!
For them. I like a straight fight, but... Gotcha.
Have a pleasant day.
Understood!
Drop my head!
Turn around very slowly.
Damn it.
Have you seen the assassin?
Why are you looking for him? You're not one of Nassana's mercs. Who are you?
Answer my questions and I'll let you go.
Look, pal. Even if I knew where he was, I wouldn't tell you.
Not the answer I was looking for.
I've got nothing more to say to you. If you shoot me, my team's right through there. They'll be all over you.
Is a little information really worth dying over? Isn't Asana?
No. I suppose not. Okay, look. Last I heard, the assassin was down on the mezzanine. But the teams on the bridge think they might have spotted him. Nobody knows for sure.
Get out of here.
I'm going.
Reach the top. I'm afraid your men aren't able to respond, Nassana. Damn it! Are you guys all right in here?
Get back! Get back! I'll shoot!
This can end quick or painful. Your choice.
I don't want to hurt you, but I will. I said get back. I'll do it. Please, don't make me do it.
Hey, I'm not the bad guy here. What's your name?
I'm Talon. Don't come any closer.
Talon, I'm Commander Shepard. I don't work with the Mercs, and I don't want to hurt you. I'm here to help.
All right. Here. Don't feel so...
Tell him! He's my brother. I just want to see if he's all right. Are you the ones who shot the Merc?
It wasn't me. What happened here?
The Merc found us and shouted at us to move. We panicked, and he shouted more. I thought he was going to kill us, then his head just exploded. Talon picked up the Merc's gun, but we were too afraid to leave. Then you showed up.
Clean shot. Very nice. I'm looking for someone. Probably the guy who killed this Merc.
Talon thought he saw someone following us, but he's been a bit on edge. I haven't seen anyone but the Mercs.
How safe is that bridge out there?
The bridge is stable, but the wind's your real problem. If it doesn't throw you off, the Mercs will definitely try. There's a lot of them out there.
Is the bridge the only way to the penthouse in the other tower?
From here, yeah. It won't be easy. Mercs are patrolling the other side. Whatever Nassana's hiding from must be pretty scary.
There are still Mercs up here. We should get to the lower levels.
No need to convince me. Tell him. Come on, get up.
Can we go home now?
Yeah, we're getting out of here. Thank you.
Yes.
about to end.
Come here!
This should come in handy.
Shepard, but you're dead.
I got better.
And now you're here to kill me.
I'm not an assassin, Nisana, but I'm looking for one.
You break in here and decimate my security just to find the person who's here to kill me? What are you playing at, Shepard?
What?
I heard something. Damn it. Check the other entrances. You. Stay put. When I'm finished dealing with this nuisance, you and I are going to...
Nice entrance.
I was hoping to talk to you.
I apologize, but prayers for the wicked must not be forsaken.
Do you really think she deserves it?
Not for her. For me. The measure of an individual can be difficult to discern by actions alone. Take you, for instance. All this destruction, chaos. I was curious to see how far you'd go to find me. Well, here I am.
How'd you know I was coming at all?
I didn't. Not until you marched in the front door and started shooting. Nasana had become paranoid. You saw the strength of her guard force. She believed one of her sisters would kill her. You were a valuable distraction.
You used me so you could kill her.
I needed a diversion. You needed to speak with me. You certainly fulfilled your end of the bargain. What would you like to discuss?
Someone's been abducting entire human colonies. We're gonna stop them. We already know the culprits. A race called the Collectors.
I've heard of them. Attacking the Collectors would require passing through the Omega-4 relay. No ship has ever returned from doing so.
They told me it was impossible to get to Ilos, too.
A fair point. You've built a career on performing the impossible. This was to be my last job. I'm dying. Low survival odds don't concern me. The abduction of your colonists does.
You're dying? Are you contagious? How long do you have?
If you're interested, we can discuss it on your ship. The problem isn't contagious, and it won't affect my work.
I hadn't heard that. Is there anything I can do?
Giving me this opportunity is enough. The universe is a dark place. I'm trying to make it brighter before I die. Many innocents died today. I wasn't fast enough, and they suffered. I must atone for that. I will work for you, Shepard. No charge.
I've heard impressive stories, Krios. Sounds like you'll be an asset to the team. That is, if you're comfortable having an assassin watch your back.
I've accepted a contract. My arm is Shepard's.
Uh-huh. Don't know about you, but I'm loyal to more than my next paycheck.
Keep it civil, people. We've all got the same goal. Maintain the objective.
Aye-aye, ma'am.
Where shall I put my things? I'd prefer someplace dry, if anything is available.
The area near the life support plant on the crew deck tends to be slightly more arid than the rest of the ship.
Ah, an AI. My thanks.
He seems quite civil.
We need all the help we can get. He's not what I expected in an assassin. He may surprise you.
Yeah. And he may not.